This part is for the girls, although it's not exclusively for girls, because guys, you can feel free to listen in. In fact, it's probably a great idea, because then you'll understand some of the things I'm going to talk about, and let's face it, you will live with and work with girls in your life. There are some changes that happen just to females. Hopefully you've worked out some of the differences between boys and girls by now, but if you haven't, let me point out a very obvious thing. Girls can have babies, and boys can't. So if you are in possession of a body that can make babies, then this information could be useful. Can I just say that it's really great to be a woman and that's what you're becoming? Unless you're one of the guys that's decided to listen into this bit, and that's cool too. I love being a woman. It's great. It's probably better being a woman now than it has ever been. In times gone by, women were much more limited in what they could do and hope for in life. And in some countries, that's still the case. There were certain careers that they couldn't choose, certain decisions they weren't allowed to make. In fact, we didn't even have the vote. But you know our story. Women got the vote in New Zealand first. So I'm glad that those things have changed. But there are still some really big hurdles that girls face, and some of the hurdles you're going to face will be ideas and attitude that boys have about girls and women. But potentially the biggest hurdle you'll face are the ideas you have about yourself. Can I just say the most awesome attitude you can have about yourself is respect. You know you've got a heap of good qualities and an amazing number of things to be proud of. Respect means that you think something is very special. If you respect something, you think it is valuable, and you honour it and treat it really well. Respect is choosing to see something or someone as precious. So what things should you respect? Well, firstly, I think you should respect yourself. Possibly nothing in your life will affect your happiness and satisfaction more than how much you respect yourself. You know you might have good looks, a good brain, a lovely family, but if you think very little of yourself, then your life will be more miserable. All the stuff in part one that we talked about self-esteem, is really important, especially for us girls. You know we're all worthy of respect. Of course we have faults and weaknesses, but we all have a place in this world and we've all got a part to play. So let's talk about men's attitudes about women. I guess some men, well, maybe they've got silly attitudes towards women, and I've decided not to let that bother me. I think lots of men are getting the idea that, yes, women have brains and amazing abilities. What bothers me more is when girls start to run themselves down. In fact, men and women are very different, but the way we can work together best is to respect our differences. Men do some things brilliantly, and that's because they're men, and women do some things fantastically because they're women. Let's talk about girls having brains. We girls have got great brains. Science shows us we use our brains in different ways from men. Go figure. They've put men and women in brain scanners and asked them to solve problems, and they've shown that we actually think differently from men. I guess people have always known this, and in the past people thought that meant that our minds weren't suitable for some things or weren't as good as the way the regular brain, the male brain, worked. But it seems now that our way of thinking is just fine for just about any type of job or role. There are now more women scientists and doctors graduating from universities than men. Women can fly planes, it turns out, lead nations and head up big business. So ladies, respect your brain. You know you might not be a genius, but you've probably got enough brain power in that head of yours to do anything you want to. You just have to learn how to tune it up and let it rip. Girls are also really strong. It is true that women have got bodies that are generally smaller than men's bodies, and on average, men are 50% physically stronger. Men can usually do physical work for longer before they get tired. Now, perhaps this was once a huge advantage for them and a limitation for women looking for work, but nowadays there are far fewer jobs that actually require huge amounts of physical effort. These days, machines do most of the hard work, and it's brain power that counts more and more. And also, women are realizing that they are tougher than they thought they were. Believe it or not, when typing was first invented, many people doubted that women would be strong enough to handle it. And of course, we have to talk about girls and feelings. Women have got great emotional strengths. Women tend to feel emotions more, or at least we show our emotions more than men. And yeah, I know we use more tissues at the movies than men do, and it used to be thought that that meant we were emotionally weak, but I think it's exactly the opposite. I think that it's actually a powerful part of our nature, and we have great emotional capacity. Yes, we do feel things strongly, and as a mother, I have incredibly strong feelings of love and protection towards my children. That doesn't make me a weak mother or a weak emotional woman. That emotion gives me courage in scary or dangerous times. It helps me to be resilient. It gets me going and motivates me. I'm not afraid of my emotions. In fact, my emotions can be a useful ally. They allow me to stand alongside a friend in a time of pain. I just need to keep my emotions in good working order. How about seeing the good in other people? Respect is a great attitude to have for other people. It's basically really easy to see other people's faults. You look at someone and you instantly notice a nose hair hanging down, or that they've got a lisp or a bulge over the top of their belt, or some other thing. Perhaps somebody has a personality thing that just bugs you. But can I say that you'll find the world a more fantastic place if you try and look past the faults that are so easy to spot? If instead you see great things about people? Because literally everybody has something about them that's marvelous, or beautiful, or unique, even the people you don't like. And having respect for people changes your world. Instead of living on a planet full of losers, when you have respect, you discover you live in a wonderful place with wonderful people everywhere. Okay, questions. Adults, what does being a feminist mean? And kids, what's your favorite thing about being a girl?